Hey everyone, it's me Sahar, and today I'm going to be filming my June wrap-up. I actually managed to read quite a few books this month despite being incredibly busy. If you guys don't watch any of my reading vlogs, which you totally should, I'll link them down below, but I've been super occupied with summer classes. I do have a part-time job and a part-time internship. And so between all of that and trying to film content for you guys, it's been pretty hard to find time for reading, but I feel like I've found a pretty good balance and I'm actually really proud of all that I managed to read in the month of June. So I'm really excited to share all of them with you guys. And without further ado, let's just get into my June wrap-up. So the first book I finished this month was The 7.5 Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle by Stuart Turton, I believe. And this was a very interesting book. I really didn't know what to expect going into it, and the way it ended, I can tell you I didn't see any of it coming at all. It definitely took a different turn and a different approach than I had expected. So this book is basically about the death of Evelyn Hardcastle and this guy named, I already forgot his name. This guy named Aiden Bishop is finding himself waking up in a different body and in a different life every single day. And each of these people that he's waking up as have something to do either with Evelyn's murder or have some kind of information that will help him piece together and figure out who killed Evelyn Hardcastle. And he wakes up with the memories of his past lives. And so he kind of uses all of this information that he's gathered to play detective and figure out who killed her. So this was very interesting. I definitely didn't expect it to end the way it did. It was an interesting plot twist. I will definitely say that I don't think this is a spoiler, but this does take on more of a sci-fi type approach, or a more, I don't want to say dystopian, but it's not necessarily just a regular world and things are all normal. So I will say that. So if you're expecting kind of a very fun whodunit murder mystery, yes, this is that, but it also has so many more elements and aspects that you really wouldn't expect. So that's something that I really did enjoy. I ended up giving this a 4 out of 5 stars, and the reason I took off a star was just because, yeah, it was really fun, it was interesting and unique, and I really enjoyed the main character. I just felt like at some points it got really repetitive because he was living the same day over and over again, just in a different body, and with that came us reading the same day over and over again. And although we were meeting a whole new cast of characters every single day, which kept it a little bit more fun and fast-paced, I felt like this book definitely dragged at some points because you had already seen the scenes at some points and you already kind of knew what was going to happen. And so sometimes it did take away from the enjoyment level that I had of this story. But overall, I definitely think it was a really good read and I would recommend you pick it up if you're interested in kind of murder mystery type things. This was pretty well done. So the next book I finished was Thunderhead by Neil Schusterman. I gave this a 5 out of 5 stars. If you guys watched any of my vlogs, you would know that I absolutely adore the Arc of a Scythe series, and I'm excited to read the final installment in the trilogy next month. And it was incredible. The ending was insane. Just the entire book was such a ride, and I enjoyed every part of it. I tabbed it up like crazy. It was so fast-paced and fascinating, and yeah, so the first book, Scythe, follows this dystopian world where people have cured all diseases and all infections and everyone is immortal. But obviously there has to be some way to control population growth, and so the only way to do that is through these things called Scythes, who are essentially people trained to kill people. And this follows our two main characters, Citra and Rowan, and they have been chosen to go through an apprenticeship with one of the coolest Scythes, in my opinion, Scythe Verde. And Only one of them is going to actually claim the title of Scythe, and the other one is gonna kind of get shunned and thrown back into society. And neither of them actually want to be a Scythe. They don't want to spend their life killing people. They don't want to be murderers for a living. So that was very, very interesting to read from their point of views and see kind of what they're thinking throughout this journey and throughout this apprenticeship. It was very, very fascinating. And I think just the writing style is really what sold me on this in the first book. Neil Schusterman's writing really meshes well with me, and I just fly through his books, and so I really, really enjoyed it, and I highly recommend the series. I usually don't really read dystopian type books, but after reading this, I'm definitely going to give them a try. So the next book I have is Furthermore by Tahara Mafi. This was really, really good. Surprisingly, I sound very surprised, and that's because I really wasn't expecting much going into this. I just knew it was going to be fun and light and magical and just really just cool and fluffy, and I did not expect this to hit so many deep conversations. This, I'm pretty sure, is marketed as a middle grade, and it definitely read that way, but it definitely hit a lot of deeper concepts about loving who you are, and it hit family relationships and tensions and that, and feeling like you're not good enough. And there were just so many topics that it tackled that I really, really appreciated, especially for a middle grade book. This follows our main character, Alice, and she is born without color in a world of color, and her father has disappeared and has been gone for years now, but she really, really wants to find him. And one day this guy comes along named Oliver, and he tells her that he can help her find her father. And so they go through this journey through this land called Furthermore. And Furthermore is this really twisted place. Nothing is exactly as it seems. And so she needs Oliver's help to guide him through Furthermore to find her father. And it was just so well done. I did give this a 4 out of 5 stars. I really, really enjoyed it. Tahara Mafi's writing style was very incredible in this. It really broke that fourth wall, and she was talking to you. She referred to you as the reader. She really was trying to get you engaged and involved in the story and really understand the characters from an outside perspective, which I think really helped and enhanced the overall story and the themes in it. The reason I did take off a star was just I really hold 5 stars for books that have a very strong lasting impact on me, and although I did really, really enjoy it, it just was missing that spark or that something, and it did take me 2 tries to get into it, so that also played a role in it. But aside from that, I highly recommend it. I thought it was really, really well done, really well thought out, and the cover being this gorgeous definitely helped, and I'm excited to read Witchwood, which I think is somewhat a continuation, but it follows a different set of characters, but we still see Oliver and Alice in it, so I'm pretty excited for that. But yeah, I do recommend this. The next book I read was 3 Dark Crowns by Kendar Blake. This was incredible. This was so dark and twisted and just nothing like I had expected it to be. I had heard so much hype around this series, and I was really, really hesitant to pick it up because I was just afraid that it would let me down, but it did not disappoint. This book follows 3 different queens in this queendom, and they all have different abilities. So we have a poisonist, an elementalist, and a naturalist. And these 3 queens have been separated at birth. They're triplets, and they have each gone to their separate little island and have learned and grown up with their special ability. And now on their 16th birthday, they have to essentially fight to the death for the throne and for the crown. And it was just so, so well done. I ended up giving this a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I did have a hard time getting into it, and that's why I took off 0.5 star. I started this, got about 100 pages in, and actually put it down like months ago, but I did a 24-hour readathon a while back, and I actually picked this up on audio, and it was definitely a good choice because the 24-hour readathon really pushed me to want to finish this book in a day, and the fact that it was through audio really helped me get through the slower parts in the beginning, and I ended up really, really enjoying it. And that ending, I need the next book. I'm so, so excited to read the next one. So the next book I have is The Last Olympian by Rick Riordan. This is the fifth and final book in the Percy Jackson and the Olympians series. This was my very first read of Percy Jackson, and I loved it. It was so, so well done. I loved Percy as a main character. He is honestly, I'm gonna make this statement and putting it out there, he is my absolute favorite character in any book that I've ever read. Reading from his point of view was so entertaining. He's so just brave and courageous, but he's also witty and funny and sarcastic, and it was just such a good time reading from his point of view. And I really, really enjoyed how this series ended. I'm excited to start The Heroes of Olympus, which is actually on my the first book is on my July TBR. I was trying to remember if it actually was or not, but this was so good. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars, or I think I gave this a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I really, really enjoy how this ended, and I'm not going to bother with a summary because I'm assuming you all know what Percy Jackson is about, so yeah, it was great. This next book I have so many feelings about. It was amazing, and I went back and forth between a 4.5 and a 5 stars, and right now if you look on my Goodreads, which is always linked in the description, I have it as a 4.5, but I'm really, really wanting to give it a 5 out of 5 stars because it was just so, so good. And that is Dark Matter by Blake Crouch. This is a sci-fi novel, and I usually don't read a lot of sci-fi. The last sci-fi book I read, I think, was 2 years ago, and it was eh. So I was very hesitant to pick this up, but I am so glad I did. I learned so much about it. Even though it is fiction, they definitely drew from a lot of actual scientific theories and a lot of scientific facts, and it was really, really fascinating to learn something while being entertained in a book, which is always just amazing. But Dark Matter basically is about this guy named Jason, and Jason Dessen, he has this amazing life. He has his wife, he has his son, and he's just having a good time. He's a scientist, but he gave up being, you know, this incredible and probably the best scientist in the world for his family and to be a family man. And so now he's just a professor at a local community college. But one day he gets kidnapped, and his kidnapper infects him with something. So he gets an injection with something, he has no idea what it is, and he passes out, and when he wakes up, nothing is as it was anymore. He wakes up in this weird laboratory, and people are, you know, still calling him Jason, but it's as if they're expecting him to be a different version of himself. And that's all I really want to say about this, because the journey to figuring out what the heck is going on in this book was really the selling point of it. We find out exactly what's going on as Jason discovers it himself, so we're just as out of the loop as he is, and we're just as confused, but at the same time very, very curious to figure out what is going on. And I loved it. It was so, so well done. And the reason that I did for now give it a 4.5 is because the middle dragged just a little bit, and that was just because, well, I can't actually say because it's a spoiler, but if you read this book, you'll understand that the reason it's dragging also has a purpose, which is why I'm kind of wanting to give it a 5 stars, because I can totally understand why Blake Crouch made the middle half of this book so, not slow, but just not as fast-paced as the beginning and the end. And that ending, amazing. I did not see any of it coming. It was so, so well done, so well thought out, and I'm really, really excited to read more of Blake Crouch's work. It was so fascinating, and I really did enjoy his writing style. So I highly, highly recommend this. Even if you're not a sci-fi reader, I I loved it, absolutely loved it. And the last book that I have to talk about is Empire of Storms by Sarah J. Maas. I literally finished this on June 30th, so perfect timing to fit this into my June wrap-up, but I ended up giving this a 5 out of 5 stars. It was amazing, absolutely amazing. I'm always worried with Sarah J. Maas books that I'm not going to like the next one in the series, or the one after that, or the one after that, and while I'm reading them, I'm like, okay, yeah, this is really, really good, but it's not my favorite. And then she hits us with the ending, and her endings, like, she knows how to write an ending. That woman is a genius. Like, these books, yeah, they're a little bit slow at times because there's a lot of world building in the first half of the series, and there's just a lot of things that are still being uncovered. There's still so much we don't know, which is something that I actually really, really appreciate, is we're not just given all of the facts and then it's just like, here's the story. You know, it's like we're really discovering and we're staying engaged with the characters and the world, and we're wanting to learn more and more as we go along. And her writing is definitely a little bit on the fluffier side, so it could feel like it's dragging at times. But the way she just ties everything together, there are parts of The Assassin's Blade, which is the first novella that took place before the original Throne of Glass book. And those concepts and those characters and that story arc is being tied into this book that's so far along the way in this journey. And I just think that is so, so well done. And just seriously, props to Sarah J. Maas, because I am very, very impressed by her ability to, one, write an ending, and two, tie everything together in a nice, pretty bow. So, if you haven't picked up Throne of Glass, I seriously do it. It's so, so good. I know it's not everyone's cup of tea. I know people hate on Sarah J. Maas. It's okay. I can see where you're coming from, but I do really, really enjoy her work. I'm not going to bore you with a summary of Throne of Glass because I'm assuming everyone knows what it's about. So, if you don't know what it's about, all you have to know is assassins, fae, dragons, witches, magic, and fighting. I feel like that summarizes the entire series. It's really good. So, those are all the books that I managed to finish in the month of June. I ended up reading 7 books, which I know some people, especially on BookTube, read so much more than that, but I'm very, very happy and pleased with myself. That's an average of over 1 book a week, and so I'm pretty proud of myself, and I'm excited to continue on this momentum in July. I did hit a bit of a reading slump back in May, but I'm excited to be back in the game, and I'm excited to document all of my reading journey and my vlogs and just these videos. So if you want to follow my journey, make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Yeah, thank you so, so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Goodbye. Down, yeah. I've been feeling so down, yeah. Can you tell me why? Can you tell me why?